Well, good afternoon and welcome to our live streaming coverage of the County Championship Finals Day here at Twickenham. We've already seen the East Midlands secure the Division 2 plate and seen defending champions Cornwall lift the Bill Beaumont Cup for a second year running. It's been the small matter of England against Wales as well, of course. Eddie Jones maintaining that winning streak after the Grand Slam. But now it's time for the Shield final, which will be fought out between Hampshire and Staffordshire. It's been 54 years since Hampshire last reached Twickenham after, trying since 1962 to reach the home of England rugby once again. Done it with relative ease this year, scoring 90 points in their two pool matches while only conceding 13. Their semi-final match against Warwickshire last weekend was a little more testing. They went behind three times during the game and only just held on for a 23-15 victory. Looking at the team then, Hampshire are captained by Wes Duggan, who sits alongside brother Wayne, each scoring a try in that seesaw semi-final. Up front, Ken Dowding is no stranger to Twickenham, having made 8 appearances for the Army in the Babcock Trophy match against the Navy. He plays alongside Ben Allman and Joe Tarrant from Bournemouth in that front row. Ramos and Worrell in the second. Joseph Rees, Stephen Crudders, Gavin Hart in the back row. Skipper Duggan, fly half. Pierre-Alex Clark at fly half. The wingers, Curtis Barnes and Wayne Duggan. In the centres, John Knight and Robert Searle. And the fullback is Alex Sutherland. For Staffordshire, the wait's been even longer. Staffordshire side has never played at Twickenham, despite winning the competition in 1970 when the match was played in Burton. Their route to the final has been a tense one. Impressive 45-36 victory away to Cumbria in their final group match set them up for a home fixture against Buckinghamshire to decide who'd reach Twickenham. Nail-biting 6-3 victory in terrible conditions, but it was enough to see them over the line, and here they are, their fully deserved moment to play on the hallowed turf at the home of England rugby. And with 28-year-old fly half Lee Brogan captaining the side, Litchfield strongly represented in all three members of the front row. Kev Burt, Dan Clark, Danny Poole, Liam Hucknall and Gazzard in the second row, Jack Neal, Sam Longstaff and Dan Smith in the back row, and at halfback Jones and Brogan, wings Palmer and Floyd. And we are ready for the teams to come out. For long-standing players such as Staffordshire's Kev Burt, Dan Clark, Carl Williams, Dan Smith and Jack Neal, as well as director of rugby Bill Leeson and under-20s coach John Aitken. Well, the final comes after years of hard work. They may feel like underdogs, but they're determined to represent themselves well. Running through the replacements then, Hampshire, Wilkie, Marks, Crown, Butterworth, Dolbear, Hiscock and Chandler. And for Staffordshire, Eldershaw, Fielding, Harden, Williams, Martin, Sant and Joe Maskery. So the sun shining down on our commentary position in the East Stand. And Hampshire in the blue and red, Staffordshire in the emerald green shirt. Neither side made the semi-finals last year, with both losing 2 out of their 3 games in the pool stages, as Leicestershire went on to beat Cumbria in the 2015 final. There'll be a new name, on the Shield for 2016. Our referee is Mick Harris, assisted by Jeff Highcock and Bob Carnell. And we are underway. Staffordshire with possession. And it's Dan Jones, scrum half, who plays at Longton. Newcastle born. And they're just finding their way down this near side. Back in from Jones. Decent early few bits of possession for the Staffordshire boys. That's a good carry from Litchfield's Danny Poole. Tight head prop. And then his propping partner, Kev Burt. South African born. Also a landlord of a pub, I understand. Good little pop up there from Brogan to Gazzard. Hampshire defence is holding fairly firm at this stage. Just getting up to the halfway line. using that combination of forwards and backs. It's now just a little bit slow, and Lee Brogan, the skipper, is going to have to play scrum half. Hampshire just defending patiently. Cutting back in field, looking for the offload, and that's good. Gazzard, the Burton lock, he can also play at back row. Ball just sitting up, all moments of miscommunication for Hampshire. Now they will get a chance to try and clear their lines, but it's not going to find touch, and it's just down the throat to Charlie Mastery, the Stoke on Trent fullback. Gets past the first tackle. Jones, Brogan, on for Richard Fielding. Not held in the tackle, will crab a few more yards given the opportunity. And Gazzard will play scrum half for Jones. Hampshire calling more defenders over to the slightly narrower side over on the far side. Oh, and it was a tricky pass to try and take. And after a sustained spell of pressure in the first 2.5 minutes or so, Hampshire will get their hands on the ball for the first time. Stafford just showing that they've got the ability to just keep going through the phases, being patient, taking the yards little by little as they need to. Rugby can be a very simple game when played right. Look after the ball, let it do the work for you. Of course, it is always more tiring to defend than it is to attack, so decent 2.5 minutes. They'll be a little disappointed they haven't perhaps got further downfield or had anything to show for that, but this is a chance for Hampshire now from our first scrum. They pick from the back. Decent tackle. Wes Duggins has got himself caught in there, so they'll need someone else to play scrum half. Elliot Worrell providing the assistance, but there's a penalty going against Hampshire during their first spell of possession. Holding on to the ball. Staffordshire getting themselves in just the right position to force that turnover. Highlight to the referee that the ball wasn't coming back. And Grant Hallam indicates that it's time to have a go for the first points of the afternoon. Utility back, can play in a few of the positions if required. Plays his rugby at Longton. Stoke on Trent Bourne. He's got under that. Has it got enough to get there? Well, it has, but it's just right of the upright. Sam Hallam initially leaving one out there.
Come on, guys.
He's in good company this afternoon. George Ford just leaving a handful out there, really, for England.
Vaseline on for me? I don't think we had a tape there.
To have world-class ambitions as a fly half. Skipper's brother Wayne Duggan just getting a little bit of attention. He's played for the Navy against the Army here at Twickenham. Sir. Also mentioned in the build-up, Ken Dowding, the tight head prop, made 8 appearances for the Army against the Navy.
Behind the King of Blue.
Opponents and then teammates. Ball is well taken by Sam Longstaff. Side to side running action as he goes into the tackle. Who's that for? Long looping pass. Attempted tackles from Joel Knight. Brogan just came off for Hampshire hand, I think. Or was it just a loose pass? He's just checking with his assistant over on the far side.
Corner of the green line, white line.
Hampshire will have the line-ins. First crowd of the day for the Division 2 plate final was relatively small. We then saw it swell with the black and gold supporters of Cornwall. They'll have a big day out at Twickenham, and it paid off for them, overcoming Cheshire in the Bill Beaumont Cup final at a 12 o'clock kickoff. But great for these teams that so many from the England-Wales International that kicked off at 3 o'clock are choosing to stay on. It's a nice spring summer day.
Advantage over. Advantage over green. Knock on.
Why not have another couple of ales and enjoy
forward pass.
The County Championship Shield final. Just a little untidy from Staffordshire. Hampshire will have possession again. If you'd like to keep in touch with us, let us know where you're watching and who you're supporting. Then my name's Nick Heath, and you can send me a message on at Rugby Media. Be great to hear from you wherever you're watching.
Have balance, you two top, please. Have balance, stay up. Stay bound. Crouch. Bind. Set.
Ball's in from Duggan.
Let's use it.
Waiting at the back. Chip downfield from Clark. It's just over the head of Nick Palmer, and then he can't get hold of it, and he's knocked it on. And that is a substantial interest gain in terms of territory for Hampshire, forcing the error
green.
From the left winger.
Yeah. No, you need to stop bringing him in.
On rushing defenders, putting on the pressure, just encouraging him to take his eye off the ball, which he did.
If he goes in, then it won't be your fault.
The unforced error. Well, you could say the forced error.
What's the point
about the Hampshire scrum in their most promising area of the field so far in these opening 8 minutes?
Crouch. Bind. Set. Hold.
Pulls in from Duggan. There's a collapse on this near side, and the penalty goes to Staffordshire.
Three,
I think
under.
The assistant down near us
straight
may have given three. That one.
Straight call, great call. Three under. Longer bind, please, sir.
Staffordshire will take play back into the Hampshire half.
I just talked to him about a longer bind as well.
Some great interaction on social media during the Cornwall game. Cornish fans all over the world in Bali, Sri Lanka, Bahrain, Dubai, in Camborne as well. Some in Birmingham as well, my director's reminding me. Exotic locations the world over. Ball's away from Jones. Little slip from Brogan, but he managed to get the ball away. Jones again, running around the corner is Gazzard. Offers himself as a strike runner, the second row. Shipped on from Burt. Coming through the middle again, Richard Fielding. Off to Dan Smith, big number eight. Then Maskery. Chip that through. A fairly shallow grubber through to the touchline. It's gained them about 8 or 9 metres, perhaps.
See green.
A couple of messages coming through. Joshua, hey, shout out to the Castle Staffs lads in Poland supporting Sam Longstaff, Dan Jones, and Ash Martin. Go on, lads. And John Lynch is at home in Stafford cheering on the boys in green. Big shout to Dan Smith and Carlos Williams.
Scrum. close to them, a little for me, mate. Thanks, sir.
Give a little good bit. To know you guys are that. There is Dan Jones.
Gets that in.
Smith feeds off to his scrum half. Then on to Brogan. Big carry from Gazzard.
Use it!
Dan Jones. A little bit of a standing start for Longstaff. That back for Brogan, did well to get hold of it. It was sort of just above the shoulder. Hallam dinks the little kick through. Nick Palmer's not going to be able to get anywhere near that. It just invites Sutherland onto the ball. And the PE teacher, 25 years old, comes forward and makes easy work of it on his own 22. High clearance kick right down the middle of the park. Staffordshire through Brogan. Looking to just try and play the corners. Oh, that one's rolled beautifully. Really nicely done from the Staffordshire fly half. Keeping the pressure up on Hampshire.
Stay where you are, please. Green. Stay.
Defensive line out for Hampshire.
Hold. No, three.
Staffordshire doing their best to go and spoil it, but I think they've done so illegally. Referee's arm is out for the penalty. Yeah, coming in from the side, the clear signal.
Given the amount of rugby played on the Twickenham surface over the last couple of days, it's holding up pretty well. Decent work to try and put Robert Searle through. Cutting back infield, then Elliot Worrell, born in Devon, one previous Twickenham appearance in 2008 in the under-18 RBS Cup final. Now the ball is hacked through to the back. Maskery, plenty of time to think about where he wanted to put it. Don't know if Alistair Ramos got anywhere near that from my position. Don't think he touched it. It will be a Hampshire throw into the line. Ball tap back for Hampshire. Looking to get going. Good little dart from Joel Knight. Played for Wales Students in the 2013 Rugby League World Cup. Good bit of rugby pedigree. Pierre-Alex Clark. Duggan looks one way. He's got himself a little bit caught indecisively there. Rob Searle. And then they're using their hands. Nice through Dowding. On to Joe Rees.
Stay on our feet, and three.
Duggan feeds that blind side once again. Ball just a little bit loose.
Knock on first, guys, by Blue.
It was a knock on just before it made its way into touch.
Blue. Scum down, green ball.
One of the Yorkshire player is just going to get some attention. But, you know, just talking about the amount of attention that the Twickenham Turf has received, the Aviva Premiership final yesterday, of course. Then we had the two cup finals this morning, England-Wales International. And now we have this game, and it's not looking too bad. Keith and his team can be very proud of the effort they've put in. They are certainly hugely committed to keeping the Twickenham Turf turning over in the pristine condition to which we've all become used to seeing it in.
Knock on by Blues, come down. Green ball. Yes, knock on first. Crouch. Bind. Set. Hold. A
little bit of chat from the Hampshire scrum half, Duggan. It's away from Jones, under pressure. Brogan's just had a little juggle of it. Off to the right. Danny Poole in there just trying to stop Hampshire getting in, but well, I thought Hampshire might have forced a turnover there. They certainly brought the ball away, but the referee says it was illegally done given they were holding on to it to maintain possession. Game hasn't quite fired into life just yet. Tom Gascoigne watching from Northampton School. Oh, sorry, watching from Northampton, supporting Stafford and my old school friend Dan Clark. Mark Barrett enjoying the match from Kiev, Ukraine, cheering for our island boys, Reese, Allman and Chandler. So, it'll be an interesting signal from Staffordshire if this kick was to go over as to where Hampshire need to be wary of giving away penalties. It's well, given it's out on the wide right, it's got to be the best part of 50 metres here for Charlie Maskery. It's not quite going to get there. Noble effort, but Hampshire will have the drop out. Sometimes the officials don't get enough praise, and we have a message from Dave Charlton. Big shout out to the ref Mick Harris, doing Northumberland proud, reffing a final at Twickenham. Quite right too. Reese watching from Cardiff, wishing the men in green the best. Go on, Jack and Danny. Staffordshire, whoa, building up ahead of steam is Dan Clark. Mention or two a moment ago.
No five, blue!
Little knock on at the base. Dan Jones wanted to take it quickly, but the referee hadn't shown him the mark just yet.
On the mark, sir.
What's going to be the choice here? Charlie Maskery fancies another shot at goal. This time it's about 10 yards further infield than the last one. A couple more messages. Gareth Williams cheering on the Bournemouth RFC boys playing for Hampshire with a cider or two in the pool sunshine.
On your ball.
How very nice, Gareth. Alex Sutherland, the fullback. Joe Rees, Ben Allman, Joe Tarrant, four of the Bournemouth starters.
Jackal, seven. Four first, not the ground.
Joshua's been back on. I forgot Ben Turner, who was unable to make it to Poland, watching in Stoke. Thanks for that detail. So, Maskery. Still scoreless in this game after the first quarter. Oh, he's got right through that one, but it's ended up sending it left of the upright.
Yes,
No one able to trouble the scoreboard just yet. Grant Hallam missing one, and then Mascari missing two long-range efforts. Not quite getting the radar active just yet. Good dynamic running from Danny Poole. Tight head prop. Chases on to chase this loose ball.
Put it down.
Sutherland did well.
Put it down.
Take it safely into touch.
Thank you, sir.
But this has given Staffordshire possession. Decent area of the field too. We saw the pure strength and efficiency of the Cornish rolling maul in the Bill Beaumont Cup final.
Stay there, sir.
Scored three tries from it. They go to the tail of the line. Forwards get around it.
That's one, you're going backwards.
Dan Clark. Hampshire have done well to get an initial drive, sending it back a metre or two. And they do decide to take it through the hands in the end, Staffordshire. Nick Palmer stepping in off his left wing, the man who plays his rugby at Leek, and Sam Longstaff. They've got four queuing up short side. Jones just took a tumble as he tried to urgently serve those four waiting. Jones off to Brogan. Oh, but then there's an interception from Hampshire, and there could be a wait here. It could be a foot race right to the opposite end. And is Robert Searle going to go the whole... Sorry, it's Pierre-Alex Clark going to go the whole way. He certainly is. The referee just has a quick look and awards the try. Well, what a breakaway. All the pressure from Staffordshire. And Clark has gone the length of the field with the interception. Ball safety so key. And it's been coughed up. Five points on the board for Hampshire. Started to just tie up here, didn't he? Feed had another 10 metres to go. Not quite sure. Charlie Mastery wouldn't have caught him. Sutherland then. To add the extras. Strikes it right footed, it's outside the right upright, it's not going to come back enough. Hampshire 5, Staffordshire 0. Tom Wilson's been in touch. Big shout out to Kev Burt from Ware. It all started at Rugeley Rugby Club. Not a bad landlord too, absolutely. Incidentally, Carl Williams ran the London Marathon this year. Deserves a win for his charity work, says John Lynch. Appreciate the message, John. Hampshire, who are in front on the scoreboard, though.
Boys.
Staffordshire not through want of trying, though. Good take from Dan Clark. Away from Jones. Brogan had one dummy runner and then found Kev Burt. Got through well. Fielding. Oh, was scragged maybe a little bit high there. Referee was right there. Nothing doing. Oh, then it's loose, and then that's an offside.
Lock on.
Disconsolate look offside. On the face of Longstaff. Touched on it in an earlier game, a moment similar happening. It's very difficult not to react when a ball like that is kicked in your direction, but it is by law a penalty. Whether that is something that needs to be looked into, it always seems a bit of a harsh call to me. Certainly if it's deliberate, then it should be looked into, but that was surely accidental. Well, clearance into touch as not been too ambitious. I think that was sliced off the side of the boot somewhat, so it's not resulted in a huge advantage for Hampshire. They will have the line out, of course. Ben Ullman, former Amersham and Chilton hooker, doesn't quite hit his mark on that occasion. Drifts over the line and ends up in the hands of Staffordshire. And it's a little loose, but they'll get a second go at it. But, well, they've said it went forward. First viewing, I wasn't entirely sure it did, but referee was right on the spot. At Rugby Media for those shout-outs if you want them. Let us know where you're watching the game. Great to have your company on englandrugby.com and on YouTube, wherever you are tuning in. Hope you're enjoying your bank holiday weekend. Maybe the sun is shining where you are. Cold one in hand, watching the live stream of Hampshire against Staffordshire in the County Championship Shield final.
Bind. Set.
Ball came back on the Staffordshire side. Referee in communication with his assistant. Wasn't too happy.
Up, asses, stability. You want to hold your body weight? The other one's not going to hold up for you. You think it's the wrong course, your fault. Oh, there it is. Let's go. Body, hold it up. Crouch. Set. Bind. Set. Hold.
Bit of movement there. And now it's at the feet of Gavin Hart.
Come on.
Duggan had a bit of work to do to get that away. That's going to bobble into the touch area, to the in-goal area. Jumped down on by Nick Palmer. Staffordshire with the dropout. What option will they go for? Something the forwards can challenge on, or do they want to send Hampshire having a go from deep? They want the chance to challenge. Ended up just being in that area that was too far, really. Wayne Duggan was the man who helped bring it down. Joe Rees.
Hold, hold.
Where's Duggan? Through Clark. Knight. Oh, was well flattened. I think Knight's managed to hold on to it there, though. And it has been recycled. Quick hands from Worrell. Wasn't the most accurate of hands, but did a job. Now away to Knight. Solid tackle on him.
Ball's there.
Certainly took the legs away. Hampshire still have it, though. Tricky one to take. Sutherland did really well and then just regathered to just probe a little chip through. We saw enough of that from Staffordshire in the opening quarter. And Hampshire just playing a bit of the percentage game themselves. Lee Brogan, the Staffordshire skipper, is just getting some attention out of your shot. Just down on the near side. There he is. Bottom of your picture. Staffordshire fly half. Just stretching out the leg. Certainly hoping he can run it off, whatever it is.
White line, corner.
Message from Gregors. Tom Gregory watching from Southampton, supporting my Tetonians teammates. Come on, Hampshire. Well, yeah, Rob Searle, certainly one of those. Pierre-Alex Clark. Ali Ramos. Harry Dolbear on the bench as well.
Fine. Oh, let's go.
Line out. Well won by Staffordshire. Just outside their 22. A little bit of off-the-ball pushing and shoving. Kick goes downfield. Easily taken by Curtis Barnes, back infield for Sutherland, and that's a good little dummy from him, and he's away, Sutherland now, and up to the 10-metre line, looking for support. It was slapped back by a Staffordshire hand, but that's all right, play on, says the referee. Joel Knight then, and offloaded to Duggan. Wayne this time, tries to field it back inside, but it now just goes to a Staffordshire hand. Bobbling around. Longstaff is chasing it. Oh, well, that's decent stepping from Palmer. Oh, sorry, from Barnes. Duggan. They're sensing they might have some width here if they can get it through the hands. It's not the tidiest. And then it's turned over. And it's knock-on advantage. Oh, ball lost forward advantage for Staffordshire. A little loose from both sides. Hampshire for a couple of moments there. Looking like it was really on as well. And we'll start again. Sutherland from his own 22. Fancy's trying to find the touchline. Gives the line out to Staffordshire just between the 10 and the halfway line. Well, Hampshire had a real opportunity there. They had plenty of men, they were coming forward. I think they just got a little bit of white line fever, got a bit overexcited. They still had a good 25, 30 metres to go to the try line. Just needed to be a case of running straight, holding the defenders and feeding it wide. Message from Jez Moss. Staff's playing well, especially the Longton lads. Come on, Havant boys, playing for Hampshire. The Rattlers are with you from Dippers. Tom Gregory, let's hope the seniors can follow in the footsteps of the Hampshire under-20s by winning their final.
Guys, get a bit tired off the defensive line. Just take another step so then you can step onto the event. Not over it, okay?
Time back on then.
Oh, no.
Dan Clark, Walsall born hooker, gets the ball in. That's a good pass away from Jones. Something for someone to run onto, and that's what was needed. Gazzard round the corner, we've seen him do that all half. Then it's Danny Poole. He's a really mobile prop, Poole. And he's shown it again there, taking a good 10 metres over the gain line. And then Brogan. Oh, he's just lost it, but I think it went backwards. Referee says it did. Jones. And he couldn't find a support player there. And it's just breaking up a little bit. Staffs have got players over to the right if they can ship it on a little bit. Kev Burt spends most of that run going backwards. Staffs again, Longstaff is the dummy runner. Really good hands from Jones, from Brogan to pick that one up off the deck. Jones to the right, going short side. Good hands from Poole, and now they've got a bit of room down that right side. Trying to duck his way through the challenges. And it's back from Jones, Brogan. Staffordshire sensing an opportunity now. They've floated it over for Palmer. Then Dan Smith with work to do. Good solid work from Wayne Duggan defensively for Hampshire. Grant Hallam then on the little loop around, hoping it'll open up for him. Was there a little bit of blocking in there? Referee says play on. Jones again. Now Brogan in at scrum half, fielding, sending it out wide, but then it has just been nudged along the deck. And that's unfortunate for Staffordshire. They were building nicely there. Perhaps just needed a couple more people to thump it up and suck in a couple of the defenders before they then went wide. As they always say, you have to earn the right to go wide.
Hey guys, knock up my green. It's got blue ball.
Big shout out to the Staffordshire number six, Jack Neal. It all started at Burntwood. That's from Josh Canning. Hashtag Burntwood bound. Defensive scrum for Hampshire to deal with. Set. Can bet that there'll be as much pressure from Staffordshire here as possible. Good area of the pitch to try and force a penalty, but it's steady enough from Hampshire, not a bother. Close hands. Rob Searle, first appearance at Twickenham. Carpenter by trade. Oh, and then a nice little turn and shimmy away from Duggan. Gets a pass out to the right, looking for his brother. Still got work to do, Wayne Duggan. Oh, he gets away from one, and now he's getting away from two. Duggan's going to go all the way and into the corner. It's a great combination from the captain to his brother. And Hampshire get try number two, with half-time not too far away. 5 minutes until the break. But Duggan to Duggan. Apparently Wes thought that he was going to get the chance to get the ball all the way over to him, but he gave it his best effort. Well, Wayne picked it up, got the hat-trick against Dorset and Wiltshire last month. He gets in at the corner for Hampshire's second try. There's one breakaway. It's going to be another difficult conversion attempt for Alex Sutherland. Sutherland to add the 2 points. Oh, we had a good sighter a little earlier, and that one is through. Brilliant from Alex Sutherland. Conversion is added. Hampshire leading then by 12 points to nil. Staffordshire certainly playing enough rugby and potentially creating enough opportunity, but they've got to be patient when they are within range. 2 breakaways for Hampshire. But you've got to take your opportunities when they present themselves, and Hampshire have managed to do so in this first half. Here's a penalty chance for Staffordshire. The 3 minutes remaining of this first half. Have the chance to get themselves on the score sheet before the break. Make that half-time team talk just that little bit easier if they can remove the donut. In they gather. Clark misfired a little earlier. This one's important. Gets it to the tail safely.
Still got in the front.
Now they're looking to set up the maul and get rumbling towards the line.
He hasn't
10 metres
yet.
Out. Oh. Last time they were in this position, they actually got the ball out and tried to run it. Referee says it's there. I think he wants them to use it. Pops out on the floor. Picked up by Burt.
Back foot, Hampshire
blue, defence
back foot,
holding
back
up. Foot. Is it Longstaff who's down, possibly?
They've
injured a shoulder, Sam Longstaff. In the meantime,
hold,
Staffordshire keep
step,
going. Step, 4 metres short now. Holding it in there. Can they get the ball to ground? Hampshire doing everything they can to stop them. And then Jack Neal going himself.
He held up, guys. 5 minutes come.
Held up.
Now he took it off over the line.
Staffordshire will have the 5 metre scrum.
Seven green. Time off. Man down. You got out of the try line, your man took it off in there.
Longstaff is just receiving some attention still. It's looking too good for Sam Longstaff. Well, it's unfortunate to see. Always good to get to a big final at Twickenham. You want to make as big a contribution as you can. And Sam Longstaff, well, he's been playing very brightly indeed. He's been one of the handier players on the Staffordshire side, but he's obviously taken a knock there. And he is replaced.
Keep it straight, fellas.
Presents an opportunity.
Crouch.
Luke Harden.
Bind.
Oh, come on. Into the last minute before the break, then.
I ask you to come left for your marks, and you've got a place to go. That's not his head. That's where
Staffordshire getting so close. Can they make it happen? Shane Dicker, big shout out to the lads from Leek Rugby Club, Palmer, Harden, Floyd and the rest of Staffordshire Rugby. Get it done this time, lads. Well, they're certainly going to hope to try and do something before this break.
Bind. Set.
Staffordshire go close quarters. How have Hampshire done enough to try and turn that over? No, it's still there for the Greens, but it was knocked on at the base, and that's just a little error that they couldn't afford at this moment. And the referee says that will wrap things up for the first half. Well, an unfortunate little error brings the first 40 to a close. Taken a little way to get going, but Hampshire have scored a couple of tries. We can have a little look at them here. This is the break for the second try. Duggan to Duggan. Wayne with a lot of work to do from this position, but he's still powered away from Nick Palmer into the corner. And then this was the intercept. Little show from Clark. And he was already flying over the halfway line. It was clear he wasn't going to get caught. Just started to tie up a little bit. Maskery closing in on him. But that was the first try of the game that opened the scoring. Perhaps slightly against the run of play at that stage, but Hampshire have been deserving of what they have created since then. It's been fairly even in terms of what the teams have tried to put together. It's finishing the chances that has perhaps been what they've lacked a little, but Hampshire have taken theirs. And Staffordshire, well, they've just got to continue to play their game. They'll be without Longstaff for the second half, who is just being led back across the pitch. But at half-time at Twickenham in the County Championships Shield Final, it's Hampshire 12, Staffordshire 0. Do keep in touch with us. Let us know where you're watching the game. My name's Nick Heath. Delighted to be with you this afternoon. And you can keep in touch with me via Twitter on @rugbymedia. Be great to find out where you're watching this game and who you're supporting. Geordie says, come on Hampshire, from all the boys at Millbrook FC. We'll be back with the second half in just a couple of minutes.
Oh, that's brilliant.
So the second half ready to get underway then. Captain. Hampshire against Staffordshire.
Captain.
In the County Championship Shield final. Thanks for joining us on englandrugby.com for this live stream or on YouTube, wherever you're watching. Lovely to have your company.
Come on,
Thomas Booth watching Hampshire in Qatar. Shout to the Island boys and the Seahawks. The longer the game goes on, the more you'll see from Joe Rees. Well, we shall see how true that is, the Hampshire number six being referred to, but Staffordshire playing from left to right in the green shirts. Hampshire playing from right to left in the blue and red.
15 green, holding on.
Hampshire getting the first penalty of the second half.
Shot.
Sutherland fancying this effort. It's a little nearer than the two opportunities he had in the first half. This would not be the ideal start to the second half that Staffordshire would have wanted. Staffordshire's coaching staff made up of Craig Wilson, Eric Field, Jim Davis. Hampshire lead coach Ian Chandler, assistants Will Knight, Dylan Rabenheimer, Neil McRoberts and Chris Jones. Manager is Simon Burns, credited with putting the right teams in place to have seen Hampshire to this point. Sutherland. He's got under that somewhat. Accuracy wasn't too bad. Staffordshire thinking about playing this out. Sutherland takes it quickly. Hampshire, oh, bit of miscommunication, but it might just work out for them as they come down the right-hand side.
On our feet, boys!
Ali Ramos made his Hampshire debut 13 years ago, but this is his first Twickenham map. Duggan, little chip through, encouraging Jones to come forward, and does eventually go into touch. Sorry, Brogan, watching that one in. Big shout out to the Longton boys from Wiff and Tammy in sunny Stoke. Mark Witcher, a huge shout out from the PRFC vets to Hampshire RFU and all of the Pompey boys involved. Longton Rugby tweeting, come on Staffs. Well, they do need to get themselves into this one. They need to get up the other end of the pitch first of all. That's where the points get scored. Jones, little low box kick. Designed to take play up the right-hand touchline. It's effective. It's a decent one from the Staffordshire scrum half.
He had it in the front still. Oh, OK, yeah, fine. He had it in the front. You could have taken it out. Yeah, you could have taken the front man.
Decent spread of players in the Staffordshire side from Longton, Litchfield and Burton. Front row is entirely Lichfield based. Here comes Staffordshire again, looking to try and get through the middle with Fielding. Decent run from him. Trying to channel a bit of Luther Burrell, who we saw getting on the score sheet for England against Wales. Good to see him putting some questions in the mind of Eddie Jones, of course, with Manu Tuilagi out of that tour to Australia. Staffordshire. Bit more direct that time. Just getting in each other's way a touch.
Release Brogan. Blue! Hold, boys.
Brogan's in there having to guard the ball. Now they get it out to the right. It's not an easy one for Dan Clark to take, so he runs it back into the middle. Well tackled by Ramos. Brogan at fly half again, often interchanging with Jones in those half-back roles.
No,
whoever gets there first takes on the duty, pretty much. That time it's Jones to Brogan. And then cutting back, Jack Fielding. Just went forward, though, in that motion.
Knock on my green.
Staffordshire building well, just prone to the odd mistake like that. William Rhodes, shout out to Pierre Clark and Jake Hiscock from the University of Winchester men's rugby first team. Come on, coach, says Liam. Water boys are on.
I'm thinking to myself, what are you coming for?
Points the gap between the two sides. Staffordshire have, well, I say they've had scoring opportunities, they've had trickier opportunities from the tee. Neither Hallam nor Masquerade have managed to slot any of the three opportunities they've had between them.
Crouch. Fine.
Balls in from Wes Duggan, Hampshire skipper.
No, get out.
Sets it back. He's going to need a bit of help because he got scragged. Clearance comes from Knight. It's a decent one as well, up to the halfway line. Staffordshire coming straight up the middle. They like trying to get Richard Fielding to bust up through that middle. They need one or two other characters who can do it. That's a really good tackle from Stephen Cruddas on Jack Neal. Neal was hoping to be the next man to punch through the middle. Now they're trying to get James Floyd away.
Release, blue!
Have they managed to get that ball to ground? They have. Jones, Brogan. Over the top, oh, nearly a hint of an interception, but they are still getting away. Luke Harden, on for Longstaff, picked up that injury towards the end of the first half, but they just ran out of turf over on the far side, really.
Touch, thank you. Yep.
It is going to be a Staffordshire ball.
Come on, blue back.
Just a moment of time off for Pierre-Alex Clark to get a bit of attention. RFU Development Officer. Born in Bath. Bit of rugby in the blood, perhaps.
Hold on, Green! 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 He's ready, let's go.
Staffordshire get that ball down, but they're going to get a penalty.
On his arm, pulling him down.
I think the man who went up was interfered with by a Hampshire arm. Now they've opted rather than going for the sticks to stick it into the corner, and actually it's a great kick into the corner. Not spared a centimetre on that one.
Do not pull it down. What's the set?
Staffordshire haven't done too badly in terms of securing the possession at these sort of lineouts, but where they have struggled is then getting that second wave of momentum you need. A team like Hampshire will always defend that first drop, and then when you regroup, it's then whether they can defend the next impulse of power. There's the first bit of defence from Hampshire, setting themselves. Now this is where Staffordshire need to get rolling. And they do start to get rolling this time. And they're going towards the line. And they are over the line. And the referee says try awarded. Staffordshire get themselves on the board after 50 minutes. Decent reward. Put some nice bits of rugby together in this final. Dan Clark, the man who's credited with the try. And a conversion attempt for Grant Hallam. He was the first man on the tee this afternoon. That's the driving maul. There's the man on the floor clutching onto it, Dan Clark. Good effort from him. Hallam. Vital points. They've gone begging.
Blue four! Blue four! Thanks, sir.
Well, they're going to need more than another penalty anyway, so Staffordshire will have to come back and get themselves another try. Hampshire 12, Staffordshire 5. It's made things a little more interesting now. Oh, on the restart, doesn't look like it's going to go 10.
Option's green.
So Staffordshire will have the decision and they'll scrum it on the halfway line. It's fascinating how obviously scores can bring teams back into it, but it's more the sway of momentum they can cause. The fact that Hampshire have then compounded that score by their restart being an error that's handed possession over to Staffordshire can just allow that sway of momentum to go away from them. Staffordshire's job is to hold on to that momentum. Really big shove from Hampshire. But they were shoving to try and twist the scrum. Referee gives the penalty to Staffordshire. Charlie Masgrave.
Telling you to go straight, not walking. Yeah,
fancies a go at this. He's had a couple of efforts. Long range towards the right. This one is.
How much does he get again?
It's about 6 inches inside his own half. Mascray. To add 3 points. Certainly got the distance. And it's got the accuracy. Staffordshire get their first kick of the afternoon on target. And Mascray makes it 1 out of 3. We won't worry about those other two for now. Hampshire 12, Staffordshire 8. Well, that will give Staffordshire some heart. 12 points the gap for so long. But now, Staffs have got themselves back into this. Some really solid running. Staffordshire's Luke Harden. He was flirting with that touchline for quite a long time. Needed to try and just move in field a foot or two. They have five. Given possession to Hampshire. What was a 12-point game is now a 4-point game. And for the neutrals that have stayed behind after England Wales, well, game on. For your thoughts on who's playing well, who's standing out, who you're cheering on, do get in touch with me at Rugby Media. Check in on your messages every so often. Oh, that ball shifted back to Graham Butterworth. He's broke. Freshly by onto himself. The field. Presents it back for Wes Duggan. Now they're looking to go wide through Joel Knight. Good long pass from Searle.
Cross the forward, Danny's Green is gone.
But Staffordshire with the advantage with the ball going forwards. Good little take at close quarters from Jack Fielding.
Advantage over now, Green.
That was very nicely done. Oh, they're just getting in each other's way again here. Ball was loose, but it was backwards. Danny Poole. Now they want to try and get over the head of Joe Rees. Pops it up for Sutherland. Decent clearance from the fullback. Message from Paul Martin in the sunny New Forest. 2 wins so far today. Hope adopted country of Hampshire can make it a clean sweep. Come on the Tots boys. At Rugby Media for your messages. Clark safely down for Jones. Another decent carry from Fielding. Bright since he's come on, Jack Fielding, the
get out, Luke.
Plays at Cardiff Met University.
Danny's penalty, playing the halfback.
There's an advantage being played here to Staffordshire. Now they've all run in to help secure this ball. Maybe be more aware of the fact that they've got a shot to nothing. Get a bit of width on it, have a go. Good solid run from Gazzard, gets past the first defender. Jones, oh, and then a breakthrough. And Brogan gets going now. Brogan manages to step through the last tackle. The advantage will be over now, but they get another penalty advantage, or they get another penalty immediately. Hampshire under all sorts of pressure.
Playing the ball. 19 blue. Off his feet, playing the ball.
Putting hands in the ruck. Trying to slow it down.
Yeah, don't leave it. You're on the floor.
Well, what did we say about momentum a few minutes ago? It's certainly with Staffordshire at the moment. Another penalty, take it down to just 1 point between the sides. Talking about the Staffs at number 17, of course, that is Luke Harden.
talking scrum or not. Oh, if you want to take
a break, thanks to Shane Dicker. It's another sound effort from Grant Hallam. Say another, that's Hallam's first successful kick. Masgray and Hallam both on the score sheet for Staffordshire, along with the try from Dan Clark. Well, so far in the second half, it's 11-0 to Staffordshire. Oh, a little juggle of it. Advantage for the knock-on will be being played to Hampshire, but they can't hold on to it themselves. And the referee will have to bring them back.
Knock-on first, in my blue. Come down, blue ball. Saw a 40-metre run too. Going straight, fellas, not around the corner.
Pippa Ellis getting in touch, supporting Hampshire, and Ben Allman, proud cousin. Good to have you watching, Pippa.
Set.
Great occasion for all of these players. You never tire of playing at the home of England rugby. Such a great stadium. Oh, and looking to go all the way himself. This could be a sensational solo score. Well, he just stepped out of the tackles. And Wes Duggan, well, that is the captain taking responsibility. Staffordshire have got to be careful to make sure that doesn't cause them to drop their heads. But Wes Duggan has done brilliantly there. As per the semi-final,
blue one.
Both of the Duggan brothers have managed to get themselves on the score sheet. Wayne in the first half, and Wes in the second.
Let's go,
Sutherland.
It's conversion. Yeah. Blue one hasn't come off yet, sir.
Successful conversion from Sutherland. Eight-point difference now. Hampshire doing just what they needed to do, with Staffordshire beginning to get that swing of momentum and feel like anything was possible. Well, Hampshire, through Wes Duggan, have done brilliantly. Seem to have their tails up a little. Oh, a little ball back in field. Came from Luke Marks, but I'm not sure his teammate was quite ready for it.
Green.
Sam Willetts cheering on Staffordshire. The Burton boys, Joe Gazzard, Jack Neal and Liam Hucknall. Staffordshire for the win from Sam, Adam and Tim. It certainly looked a little more possible just a few moments ago. Certainly not out of it. 17 minutes of the game remaining. Hampshire 19, Staffordshire 11. The last of our county championship finals at Twickenham for the 2015-16 season.
the push, boys. Krauts. Fine.
Well, we are taking a while for this scrum to get down.
Ball's out.
And the ball is in.
Ball is out. Play.
Staffordshire. Whipped away.
Oh, boys.
Jones in there. Looks to work the short side. Just a little too close to the touchline. Hampshire quite happy to deal with that. Time off called by the referee. Scoring was opened by Hampshire on that breakaway from Pierre-Alex Clark. Then Wayne Dugan doing really well to run away into the corner, converted by Sutherland. That gave us the 12-0 score at half-time. Since the break, it was Dan Clark who got over for the try for Staffordshire. And we had a penalty each from Mascray and Hallam. But Wes Dugan, the Hampshire skipper, a bit of individual brilliance has seen him get through, and the conversion from Sutherland has given Hampshire this 8-point lead as things stand. Hampshire coming forwards. It's there for Dugan again. Oh, and it might be a big gap through the middle for Clark. And Clark's got supporting run of Joel Knight, and that could be decisive. Hampshire celebrate under the uprights. We do still have 15 minutes to go. And that could be critical in this game. A third try for Hampshire. Great awareness from Joel Knight that as soon as he saw his fly half go straight through the gap to support on his shoulder to get around the last line of defence. It was a well taken try. You can see here, Clark, the little show. Just too big a gap between the two Staffordshire defenders. And easy enough to send Joel Knight through. Conversion is good as well. With the conversion. Hampshire 26, Staffordshire 11. Could that just be a little bit too much work for Staffordshire to do in the last 14 minutes?
Don't swim, Pop!
Also, the more assured Hampshire start to feel, will they start to free up and play a little? We heard pre-match how Staffordshire have felt like the underdogs going into this one. Great achievement for them to get to the final. Certainly got themselves back in it. Hampshire trying to put their pedal to the metal now. And they're coming away again. Luke Chandler on that occasion made his county debut a month ago against Dorset and Wiltshire. Hampshire still have it into the Staffordshire 22. Dugan, Clark, pops it up for Butterworth. Dugan, Clark, they go to the right again. Joel Knight, try scorer. Just doesn't believe he's going to be tackled or put down, just keeps going. Clark again. Couple of dummy runners. Then it's Ullman.
Green, work hard, step, step.
Dugan wants to go down the short side. Joe Rees carries. Just gets it away out the back for Chandler. Chandler stepping through, needs support. Gets it. The line is that close.
Went back off Green. Green.
Hampshire pick and go. Luke Marks trying to get round the corner. Oh, it's just been knocked forward at the bottom there. Heartbreaking for Hampshire. Felt that they were building towards try number four. Relief for Staffordshire.
Green 15. Thanks, sir.
Come on, Hampshire, watching from Hailing Island and supporting the brother-in-law, Luke Marks. It's a family affair from Richard Chandler. Sam Willits encouraging the staff's boys. Come on, it's not all over. Not quite right, too. 12 minutes left on the clock. Ryan Corbett, hashtag Dan Jones is on fire. Staff's looking great. Head up, lads, you can do this. And Lucy Martin says, bring on Brad. She's referring to Brad Eldershaw.
I'll penalise you if you don't take that step for me, guys.
Replacement for Staffordshire. Can Hampshire join the likes of the East Midlands and Cornwall as winners on this county championship finals day?
Crouch. Bind.
Hampshire will apply as much pressure as they can here. Dan Jones gets that ball in. Staffordshire do get a decent shove on it. It's popped out on the Staffordshire side, but the clearance under pressure has handed possession over to Hampshire. Richard Fielding just feeling one on the foot a bit there after that one. Ben Ullman gets that in. They're going for the catch and drive, Hampshire. Oh, but they've been penalised for it. They got a man in front of the drive. Got to be accurate if you're going to do it. Oh, and a bit of back chat for afters as well.
17 blue obstruction.
Staffordshire. Need to rediscover that energy they had about 10 minutes ago. Got to create it themselves. Difficult to do, but if they want to try and turn this one around, that's what needs to happen. Ball in from Clark, tap down. Jones, Brogan, then through the middle. Really good tackle, Stephen Crudus. He's been excellent defensively today. Jones looking to try and pick round the fringes. Makes an extra couple of yards. They need to get that ball back. Jones looks to the right. Replacements there in Carl Williams. Jones, Brogan. Little shorter ball for Dan Smith. Brogan will have to play scrum half, and they throw the longer ball out. Williams gets through the tackle of Luke Marks. Brogan.
Lost it. Let's go.
Big carrying replacement unit. Luke Harden again involved, but possession is with Hampshire as Sutherland carries it up to their own 10-metre line. Oh, they attempted the long ball. There was nearly an interception from Joe Maskery. He was in the perfect position, but he just couldn't quite hold it. It'll be a scrum to Hampshire. Keel Women's Rugby. Big shout out to Eldershaw, Longstaff and Jones for Staffordshire, doing the Keel rugby family proud. Gregors is back on. Bring on Dolbear. Well, maybe time for the replacement scrum half. We will wait and see. 8.5 minutes remaining. Might struggle to take the skipper Wes Dugan off at this rate. Still hassling and harrying.
Crouch. Bind. Set.
Oh, the scrum not steady enough. For that ball to get in there.
Crouch, bind, set.
Oh, we've got the ball into the scrum at last. Pops up for Dugan. Clark. Oh, and then they lose it. They waited that long to get possession from that scrum, and then they couldn't do anything with it. And Dan Jones has jumped on it for Staffordshire. Looks out to the right for Hallam. And they go through the hands, finding Will Sant from Ash Martin. Offloading it to Dan Smith. Looking to try and get the number 8 to set it up, which he does. Then it's away from Hallam, through Brogan. Jones in the middle, trying to find a way to step through the holes. Does manage to find one, but the offload is, I think, meant to be stylish, but it was just haphazard, really. Poole, that's a decent ball over the top, and they've tried to ship that on, but it's gone forward. Staffordshire have just got to get the basics right. Trying to add a little bit of flair to make things happen, but got to make sure.
Blue 9, blue 11. 9. Nine. 11. Replacement.
And the changes are coming now.
Let's go, players, let's play.
Where's Dugan? 5 minutes, boys. Is leaving the field. Mark Witch, a big shout to Darren Crabb, nearly a veteran.
Crouch.
From which JP and the boys.
Bind. Set.
Dolbert.
Halfback, stay up.
Replacement scrum half. Gets that ball away. High ball hoisted. Oh, it was a little bit misread by Joe Maskery. But then he makes himself available to try and help tidy it up. Staffordshire get a ton of bodies back, but not in time. Ball was held on the floor, and look at the meterage gain that Hampshire have got out of that. A scrum inside their 22, and now they have a penalty.
Thank you, sir.
Between the 10 and halfway line in Staffordshire ground, and they're going to have a chance to, I think, pop this one into touch and get a line out.
Yes, sir. 22 green, holding on.
Sutherland. Gone for some meterage up to the 22.
Take the corner, green. Take the corner, please. Thanks, boys.
Well, it wouldn't be beyond imagination for a 20 metre catch and drive, but we saw them attempt one earlier and they just got a man in front of the ball. So will it be a little training ground move for the backs to run? Dolber certainly looking up. Got the signal from Clark. Have a go yourself around the fringes. Clark didn't want to get his back line going just yet, but he might get the chance to now. Little ball back in field. It was read well enough by Staffordshire.
Release! No, release, green!
Dolber again. Needed a carrier. Found one in the form of one of his forwards teammates. Then it's a little looser, Rob Searle.
Rolling into the tackle area.
Green penalty.
Blue penalty. Number two, green.
Staffordshire's Dan Clark just lying on the wrong side there. So Dolbert.
Still playing penalty there.
Another big carry by the back row on that occasion. Then the ball's just spilled out on the knock on. So they'll go back for the penalty against Clark for not rolling away. Being on the wrong side. I imagine this one is going to go into the corner. Certainly is.
Discipline, guys. Come on, please. Mark, am I yours?
Little short one to the front.
Hold. Let's go.
And the rest of them crowd around it, but the referee not happy again.
There's no one there.
Technically not accurate in their catch and drive technique. It's letting Staffordshire off the hook.
Instruction. You transferred it, no one was much touching.
Boys in green are certainly tiring. Hampshire really keen to try and turn the screw and get over the 30-point mark with a catch and drive try, but they can't get the basics of forming it right. ...15 points between the sides. 2 minutes remaining on the clock then. Staffordshire, oh, it's gone over the top. Little slip at the back. Dolbert. Through Clark, then a little dink through, but it will be taken by Staffordshire, who run it into touch through Will Sant. Presents Hampshire with another chance to go for that cherry on the top score. Now they bring it down. And it's just a one-man drive. Well, there wasn't much interest from Staffordshire to make the tackles in the first place, and they just wandered through. A look of a bit of shock and surprise on the face of Carl Williams. And Hampshire do get try number four, and they didn't have to try too hard for it in the end, did they? Probably couldn't believe how easy that was in the end. He didn't even need to form any form of maul. It was a one-man maul. Clock is ticking down. This is going to be the last act of the match. Alex Sutherland. Nail another conversion at the home of England rugby. He certainly can. It sails through the uprights and Hampshire get themselves up to 33, Staffordshire on 11, and the referee will blow the final whistle. That is how things have finished, and it's hugs all round for Hampshire. They got an early breakaway score from Clark, then Wayne Dugan's score
took it to 12-0 before half-time. A good fight back from Staffordshire. They got it down to a one-point game before Wes Dugan then scored a great solo effort. They then managed to put Joel Knight through. And then finishing it all off, the number eight, Gavin Hart. Hampshire with some really good bright sparks throughout the team. And Staffordshire, well, it was perhaps just one game too far. Delighted to have got here. And they were able to compete for around 60, 65 minutes. But beyond that point, Hampshire were able to get themselves over the line. But another great final to enjoy here at Twickenham on the County Championships finals day. And the Shield final winners for 2015-16 are Hampshire, with a final score of Hampshire 33, Staffordshire 11. Well, it's been wonderful having your company for all of the finals that we've enjoyed today. Congratulations to the East Midlands, to Cornwall and to Hampshire, who are all having their names etched on the trophies. Of course, well done to England as well earlier, beating Wales here at the home of England Rugby. But that about concludes our live streaming coverage. Our pictures will stay on the celebrations for a few minutes. But certainly from me, Nick Heath, it's been great to have your company wherever you've been watching on englandrugby.com and on the live stream on YouTube. Have a lovely rest of your bank holiday weekend and enjoy our pictures as Hampshire celebrate being the winners of the County Championships Shield Final for 2016. A very good evening.